Penguin Random House Audio presents Find Your Extraordinary. Dream bigger, live happier, and achieve success on your own terms. This is the author, Jessica Herrin. Part 1, Happiness Equals Success. Chapter 1, Say Goodbye, Ordinary. Be daring, be different, be impractical. Be anything that will assert integrity of purpose and imaginative vision against the play-it-safers, the creatures of the commonplace, the slaves of the ordinary. Cecil Beaton. What if I told you that, with a little effort, you could live an extraordinary life? A life in which you felt deep passion for what you did, and you always had time for what mattered to you. A life in which you made your most important dreams come true, all while happily leaving behind feelings of inadequacy or guilt, discarding them as if they were corsets from the 19th century. These days, there's a lot of discussion about whether women can have it all. This book isn't about having it all. It's about having what matters most to you. This is a book about achieving your boldest dreams and ambitions, but doing it on your terms. I wrote this book to help you find your own version of extraordinary, to help you dial up the sound of your own voice so you can tune into your authentic dreams and develop the will to make them reality. Now, let's just get this out there. It's a tad presumptuous of me to tell other people how to be successful, isn't it? Doesn't it mean I think I'm successful enough to be an expert in the matter? Well, I do consider myself successful, but not for the reasons you might think at first glance. I've done a lot that I am proud of. I graduated from Stanford, and I've been on the cover of the New York Times, called out for being a serial entrepreneur and founder of two successful companies, Della & James, which became WeddingChannel.com, and the company I currently run, the Stella Dot Family Brands. And I've had some amazing life experiences. I've been on Oprah, I've gone to Buckingham Palace to meet the Queen of England, I've been in the Wall Street Journal, and I've had my face broadcast 8 stories high in Times Square after ringing the closing bell at NASDAQ for the Stella Dot Foundation. That was fun. Did sheer luck have something to do with my success? Yes. I was born in the United States, where education is widely available to both genders. I graduated from college in 1994, right around the time women in the United States began earning college degrees in equal numbers with men. Oh, and least I forget, I went to college in the heart of Silicon Valley right before the commercialization of the internet and right after the economy recovered from a recession. Since I sought my first job when the economy was strong, it was easier to take risks, knowing I could always go back and get the safe job. The way society looked at work was changing too. There was a decided shift away from looking at a 25-year tenure at one company and a gold watch at retirement as the pinnacle of success, to seeing dropouts and innovators as business heroes. I was also born into a time when women could play more than menial roles in the workforce. Though our ancestors were around for about 6 million years, modern humans evolved only about 200,000 years ago. Civilization as we know it is only about 6,000 years old, and industrialization started in earnest only in the 1800s. The 20th century saw the Great Depression, 2 world wars, and the Vietnam and Korea wars. With all that hardship, women finally began to enter the workforce. Remember Rosie the Riveter? But only with the feminist movement of the 1960s did women begin to enter the professional world in great numbers. And we've been gunning to break the glass ceilings ever since. So, of the 200,000 years in which I could have happened, I was born in 1972 in the United States of America, in the midst of this cultural revolution. I won the lottery of time and place when it comes to women and work. But it wasn't just luck that got me where I am today. In fact, I find it to be true that the harder you work, the luckier you get. And it wasn't just what I was born with, though it's also true that some of my personality traits lend themselves to taking the road less traveled. I would not be where I am if it were not for other skills and characteristics that I've developed along the way. Independence and confidence, passion and drive, decisiveness and tenacity are all traits of the iconic entrepreneur. In the end, these traits that have made me successful are the ones that you can develop too. They are the habits of mind that allow you to think for yourself and believe in yourself beyond reason, to work hard and find the love in that, to take risks and not be afraid to fail, and to surround yourself with positive people who lift you up. That's the spirit of the entrepreneur in a nutshell. This book will show you how you can find this spirit within yourself. But my goal is far more ambitious and rewarding than just showing you how to create a successful company. My goal is to help you create a fulfilling, happy, and successful life on your terms, That's what extraordinary is all about. I went through times in my life when it looked as if I was successful, but I wasn't really fulfilled or completely happy. Trying to chase other people's definition of success instead of your own, I discovered only looks good on TV. It meant nothing in my own heart and soul. I see myself as successful today, not because Oprah or the New York Times says so, but because I've learned that only I decide what success looks like for me. I've learned to believe in myself beyond reason and to forgive myself my many flaws and mistakes. I've boldly jumped into new adventures that I knew nothing about and figured it out as I went. I've learned to stay the course, even when obstacles were in my path and people thought I was crazy. I've given up the guilt about being a working mom, knowing that I am both a great mother and a very busy, very ambitious CEO. I have learned to push forward into rooms and roles most often held by men without changing the woman that I am. I've learned to work hard on the right things without sacrificing my sanity and my health. Today, only I define my success, and only you can define yours. An ordinary definition of success is making money, moving up the ladder, and being well regarded by others. Extraordinary success, however, includes doing well at something you love and being well regarded by those who matter most to you, especially yourself. It's about learning what you want, developing the confidence to admit it, and having the grit to go out there and get it. If you are living your life in accordance with your own values and pursuing your own version of happiness, you're being authentic, and that's what leads to success. Success is not about a corporate ladder where the next run could feel more like a booby prize. One size does not fit all. Happiness doesn't come from success. It is success, because if you're happy, then you've succeeded in the most extraordinary way. Embracing the entrepreneurial spirit. Embracing your entrepreneurial spirit doesn't necessarily mean becoming an entrepreneur. This book is not a how-to on starting a company in Silicon Valley, though you might pick up some tips along the way. In fact, I firmly believe that following that path would not make most people happy. That's a good path for calculated risk-loving mavericks who are ultra-intense and somewhat strange, but it isn't the path for everybody. As my sister Julie once said to me, in a way only a sibling can, don't expect other people to want to do what you do. You're the one that's weird. When I talk about the spirit of an entrepreneur, I'm describing not just me, but anyone who wants to take charge of his or her own life. Where am I coming from with all of this? Let me first explain a bit more about what I do and why the vantage point I've gained has given me the insight to write this book. I started a business out of my living room that grew into the Stella Dot family of brands, Stella Dot, Keep Collective, and Ever Skincare, which operate in 6 countries and have empowered over 50,000 independent business owners to embrace their entrepreneurial ambitions on their own terms. Through Stella Dot, I focused on changing the lack of flexibility in the workplace that sidelines too many women as they seek to find a balance between a day job and one of the best jobs, motherhood. Both our Stella Dot mission and model are designed so that women, and a few good men, can start a business with very little investment and choose to run it either part-time to earn extra money or full-time to earn more. One word lies at the heart of the Stella Dot mission: choice. Everyone has the same start, but everyone chooses their own goals and their own pace. They don't have set hours or sales quotas, and they don't carry inventory or do deliveries. In fact, it's so flexible that 80% of our sidepreneurs operate their business alongside other jobs outside the home. Being a part of Stella Dot has allowed me the opportunity to see thousands of wildly different people approach the same opportunity in wildly different ways, producing wildly different results. What I've observed has only strengthened my opinion that it's the individual's will that determines his or her own success, not innate abilities or their past or present circumstances. When I first started Lux Jewels, the original name of Stella Dot, I wanted to do everything I could to help others be successful. So we iterated our product line, our training model, and our sales tools until we thought they were the best they could be. I realized that nothing can ever be perfect, but I wanted to get as close as possible. Several years in, I felt we had done it, created a powerful business platform that worked when you did. In the decades since, our independent business owners have earned more than $300 million in commissions from selling over $1 billion in products. Yet, I always ask myself, is there more that we can do? Yes, and that is my motivation for writing this book. I want to help more people cultivate their will so they are able to create their own way, regardless of their goal. I want to show others how to dig in and figure out their own extraordinary path and discover that to connect I want to I have, you have to be willing to insert I will in the middle. However, though I share many insights from this journey of building the company, this is not a book about Stella Dot. And let me be clear.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.